Hello friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, my name is Michaela and I make adult coloring videos here on this channel. And today I'm doing a little bit of a different kind of video, and that is my top 5 tips for starting a coloring YouTube channel. Honestly, I don't really know how well this video will go over just because I don't know how many people are out there looking for advice on starting a YouTube channel. I'm personally not the most qualified person to give advice. I'm only at about 750 subscribers. That being said, I have really hit a boom in subscribers in the last 2 months, 1 month, 2 months, since I started just consistently posting coloring videos. So I figured I would just give 5 of my tips and tricks for starting a coloring YouTube channel. You could transfer some of this over into other niches on YouTube, but I'm really focusing on coloring. Tips in this video, let me know in the comments if this is helpful, and let's get right into the video. So I've done this cute little thing where I put post-it notes on top of all of the tips so I can just take them off. But number one, it's really hard to see, my tripod's in the way, but be consistent. I personally like watching YouTubers who post once or twice a week. That being said, that has never deterred me from watching a YouTuber if I like them enough. I just think being consistent in terms of uploading really does help growth. That doesn't mean that you won't get growth if you don't upload consistently, but what I've noticed is that being consistent has helped me grow, especially being consistent in uploading coloring videos 2 to 3 times a week really has made my channel start to grow. I've gained subscribers every day, and I've noticed that was really helpful. Be consistent also in the sense of staying pretty true to your niche. So you guys might or might not know this, but when I started uploading videos on YouTube, I actually started out as a lifestyle YouTuber, and then I uploaded a coloring book collection video, and that blew up. I mean, didn't like blow up, but it blew up in this community a little bit. And I ended up gaining a lot of views from there, so I decided, oh, what if I incorporate coloring into my channel? And I grew from that. But I think majority of my audience came for coloring, and I didn't grow as much as I am now just uploading coloring videos, if that makes sense. So I think it's really important personally to like stick with a kind of specific topic. Again, that's completely personal preference though. That's just what I've noticed has helped me grow, was staying within the adult coloring kind of niche. That's kind of helped me grow. But uploading a video also at least once or twice per week has helped. And I know people are busy, and I know people tend to upload when they have time, and that's totally okay, but sticking with a schedule can be really helpful. It's been helpful for me, at least in terms of growth. Number 2 is upload popular videos. So that would include things like coloring book collection, finished pages, hauls, tags, etc. Basically, searchable content is really important to kind of upload. So the things I named off are pretty searchable content. So like if you make a video that, so like my mandala color of the month, I feel like you wouldn't necessarily be searching for that kind of video. So I wouldn't suggest making a video like that to begin with, but uploading something like a coloring book collection, finished pages videos, super searchable. People love that stuff. I know I love those kinds of videos. So videos that people can easily search and find, and that's how people found me to begin with, was my coloring book collection video. Truly, I'd suggest that being your first video, or a haul, or a finished pages, and tags that are going around the community at the time are really helpful also. Tip number 3, thumbnails. Again, I'll admit this is personal preference. I know people that have had really good success with their YouTube channel without the thumbnails. Like their thumbnail tends to be like a standstill clip from their video of a really nice completed page. Some people get really good growth with nicer thumbnails, like done and you can create them on Canva. I'm just trying to keep thinking like how to word this, but like thumbnails tend to be important, especially keeping them kind of consistent with all your videos. So when people go back to your video, they can be like, oh, I know this by the thumbnail. Like, they see your video show up and they're recommended and you go, oh, that's Michaela's video. So, I don't know. Like, I think thumbnails are pretty important. I personally recommend making them look a little, like, nice on Canva, do a cute little font, make it look appealing. I've noticed, like, I personally watch videos that have thumbnails pre-made versus those of just standstill videos. Again, it really depends. Like, it's just what I've noticed has helped me grow. Number four, Instagram. Make a coloring Instagram. I mean, it's just another platform that you can post your finished pages and connect with people, and I think that's super fun and important. I actually had a coloring Instagram, and I still do. It's actually coloring underscore ba. Oh, no, I changed it. It's Michaela Renee Coloring now. It's linked down below. I completely changed the name on it. What was I even saying? I started my Instagram before I made a YouTube channel, and that's actually where I met some of my really close friends today on YouTube. So Danielle, Danny Buttons, I met on Instagram before I started a YouTube. Cassie, Potato Princess, I met Instagram. Kate's Coloring Haven. I met all these people on Instagram before I came on YouTube, and so just, it's fun to make a coloring Instagram. You can share finished pages on there, you can add things to your stories, put polls, interact with your audience a little bit more, and it's just kind of another platform for you to share things with, and it also gives you a space besides just YouTube comments to interact with your audience and new people. And I've also just, like, included things, like, on my story, and I post, like, oh, this video went live, have you seen it yet, yes or no, and then I do things like, I'm so close to blank blank subscriber number, will you help me get there, I'm already subscribed, no, I'll go subscribe now. And I've actually gotten people to subscribe that way, because they follow my Instagram, but they don't know I have a YouTube, so I just suggest it. Last, but certainly not least, make friends. It's so fun, and I have met so many great friends here on YouTube. I can't even name them all, but, like, I've made so many great friends here on this platform, like, and we all have the same hobby, obviously, and it's great. It's so fun. In terms of making friends, I would suggest commenting on other ColorTubers' videos, but that being said, please, 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 please don't self-promote on someone else's video. That is absolutely my biggest pet peeve. I understand if you like someone's content, saying that you like it, and you can comment whatever you want, but don't necessarily mention your channel in every comment that you make. Again, this really hasn't happened to me, but I just want to put that out there, because self-promoting, it doesn't really look good on you, and I know you want to get your content out there, but there's much better ways to do that, like organically growing versus telling people necessarily that you have a channel. Again, make an Instagram, post about it on there. Just don't put that out there on someone else's hard work, if that makes any sense. And I hope I'm not being, like, a bitch for saying that, but that's my take on it. It might be a hot take, I'm not really sure, but that is it for my top 5 tips for starting a coloring YouTube channel. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button down below, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.